session we have studied about buccal cavity and its part, and also about structure of teeth. In this lecture, I am going to tell you about types of teeth. There are four types of teeth present in human beings, including mammals. On the basis of structure and function. So, types of teeth. Teeth are four types on the basis of structure and function. First one is incisor. Second one is canine. Third one is premolars, and fourth one is molars. So there are four types of teeth: incisor, canine, premolars, and molars. As I told you that the categorization of teeth or types of teeth is depending upon the basis of structure and function. So all these four types of teeth have different structure and function. What is incisor? Let's see location of incisor. They are located at front. They are 8 in number. Four in each jaw, four in upper jaw and four in lower jaw. Shape of the incisor is, they are chisel shaped. And function of the incisor is cutting and gnawing of food, or we can say nibbling of food. So incisor, they are located at front of the jaw and they are 8 in number, 4 in each jaw, that is upper jaw and lower jaw. They are chisel in shape and they are used for cutting and gnawing of food. Next, canine. They are located either side of incisor. They are 4 in number, 2 in each jaw, that is upper jaw and lower jaw. They are pointed teeth. Pointed teeth and used for tearing and shearing of food. Used for tearing and shearing of food. Third one is premolar. Located laterally they are also 8 in number, 4 in each jaw. They have two cusps and used for crushing and grinding of food. Next one is molars. They are also located laterally next to premolars. next to premolars, they have three or more blunt cusp and also used for crushing and grinding of food. So let's have a quick review, recap of types of teeth. Incisor, as I told you, the categorization of types of teeth on the basis of a structure and function means each and every teeth has different structure and function. Let's see what is incisor. Incisor located at the front of the jaw. They are 8 in number. That means 4 in upper jaw and 4 in lower jaw. They are chisel shaped and used for cutting and gnawing of food. Next is canine. Canine located on the either side of incisor. They are 4 in number, that is 2 in upper jaw and 2 in lower jaw. They are pointed teeth. Mainly canines are the characteristic teeth of carnivores and used for tearing and steering of food. Next one is premolar, located laterally next to canine, and they are also 8 in number, have 2 cusps and used for crushing and grinding of food. Molars, they are located laterally just next to premolars. They have 3 or more blunt cusps and used for crushing and grinding of food. Let's understand all the 4 types of teeth and their location with the help of diagram. As I told you, incisor is present at the front and they are 8 in number. They are 8 in number, 4 in each jaw. So, I'm just writing I for the incisor. So, the front 4 teeth are incisor in lower jaw, and these front 4 teeth are incisor in upper jaw. Next, type of teeth I told you, that is canine, and they are 4 in number, 2 in upper jaw and 2 in lower jaw, and they are located on the either side of incisor. So on the either side, this is canine and this is canine and this is canine, this is canine. So how many numbers of canine in total? 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Next type of teeth is premolar, and they are 8 in number, 4 in each jaw. This is premolar. I'm just writing PM. This is premolar. This is premolar. This is premolar. So this is premolar. So, and this is also premolar, and this is also premolar. So, they, as I told you, that they are 8 in number, so, and located laterally. They are located laterally, and they are 8 in number, 4 in upper jaw, 4 in lower jaw. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 in upper jaw, 1, 2, 3, 4 in lower jaw, and total 8 in number. Next is molars. That is, they are 12 in number. They are 12 in number and 6 in each jaw, that is 6 in upper jaw and 6 in lower jaw. They are also located laterally next to premolars. So, they are molars. I am writing molar, M for molars. They are also molars. 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 They are 12 in number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 6 in upper jaw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 in lower jaw. So, there is a symmetry in our jaw. The horizontal symmetry as well as vertical symmetry. So, on the half of this we can calculate the dental formula of adult. Dental formula of adult. If we are counting in this portion of the jaw, if we are counting teeth in this portion of jaw, so 2 is incisor, 1 is canine, 2 is premolar and 3 is molar. Similarly, if you are trying to count in this side of jaw, then 2 incisor, 1 canine, 2 premolar and 3 molar. So here I can, you can see that here is a symmetry, that is vertical symmetry in upper and lower jaw as well as horizontal symmetry. You can see here 4 incisor here and 4 incisor in the lower jaw. 1 canine, 2 canine in the upper jaw and 2 canine in the lower jaw. 2 premolars. So 4 premolars in the lower jaw and 4 premolars into upper jaw. Similarly, 3 molars and 3 molars. So 6 molar in upper jaw and 6 molar in lower jaw. Behalf of this, we can calculate, or we can say we have the, divided it into 4 parts. So how many number in this chamber, this portion of jaw, how many teeth are? So let's, incision, how many? There are 2 incision in upper jaw as well as 2 incision in lower jaw. We are just talking about this portion of teeth. So 2 in upper jaw and 2 in lower jaw. Let's move to the canine. 1 in upper jaw and 1 in lower jaw. So we can write it here like that. 1 in upper jaw and 1 in lower jaw. Next, 2 premolars in the upper jaw and 2 premolars into the lower jaw. So 2 by 2. And similarly, 3 molars in the upper jaw and 3 molars into the lower jaw. So 3 by 3. We have counted this portion, we have counted teeth of this portion of jaw, but we left this portion of the jaw. So by multiplying it with the 2, we can get, if we multiply it by 2, then multiplying it by 2, then what it got? 4 and 4, and what it become? 2 and 2. And what it become? 4 and 4. And what it become? 6 and 6. So by counting these two numbers, what we get? 32. So total number of teeth in a human adult is 32. And we can calculate it like this. And this is called dental formula. In general, we can say 2123 upon 2123 into 2 gives us 32. But we have to memorize the sequence of the teeth, incisor, canine, premolar and molar. Let's see types of teeth on the basis of number of times they erupt. Or appear in lifespan. So there are two types of teeth on the basis of number of times they erupt or appear. One is temporary teeth. They are also referred as milk teeth or deciduous teeth. Deciduous teeth. We can call it as temporary teeth or milk teeth or deciduous teeth. Next is permanent teeth. Permanent teeth. Let's see what is temporary teeth. They start or they begin to erupt her appear at the age of 6 months to 12 years. Sorry, 6 months, and generally lost at the age between 6 to 12 years. They just appear at the age of 6 months and lost at the age of 6 to 12 years, and they are 20 in number. How many milk teeth are present in human beings? That is 20 in number. Earlier I told you that human have total number of teeth, that is 32. So, and they are called permanent teeth. And they are called permanent teeth. It means they begin to erect at the age of 6 years to the adulthood. And they are 32 in number. So, which teeth is absent in male teeth? Let's see. And what is the dental formula of child? Dental formula of child. It is incisor, again 2 by 2, canine 1 by 1, and you know the meaning of 1 by 1, that is one canine in upper jaw and one canine in lower jaw. Premolars, they are 0. It means, if I am writing 0, it means premolars are absent in the milk teeth or deciduous teeth. And next is molar, and they are 3 in number, but in case of child, last molar, that is wisdom teeth, is absent. So total number of molars in milk teeth is 8, that is last wisdom is absent. In case of milk teeth, or in case of child, last molar is absent. So I'm just removing it so that you can clearly understand it. Last molar is absent, and this last molar is also absent, and this last molar is also absent. And as I also told you that premolars is also absent. So you're trying, you must be confused that premolars are here. So how it can be possible that premolars are absent and molars are present? In place of premolars, in case of children, in place of premolars, molars are erupted. So here premolars, instead of premolars, in case of children, they have molars. In similar way, here also they are molars. They are molars. And here also, if I am saying in case of children, premolars are absent. So I am just removing that teeth, and they are molar. And they are also molar. Don't get confused. In place of premolars, molars are erected. and when they lost premolars comes and they become permanent teeth. So they are molar. Now try to find dental formula. As I told you, let's see this portion of the jaw, that is lateral portion or right portion of the jaw. Two incisors in the upper jaw. So dental formula 2 by 2. One canine in upper jaw, one canine in lower jaw. So 1 by 1 in upper jaw. And as I told you, premolars are absent. And instead of, in place of premolars, what erupted? That is molars. So in place of premolar, we just write it down 0 by 0. And in case of molars, we just write it down 2 by 2. So, and by multiplying it 2, we get 20 teeth. As I told you that temporary teeth or deciduous teeth are 20 inch long. Let's understand the complete human dentition. What is human dentition? Arrangement of teeth. Arrangement of teeth on jaw is referred as human dentition. Arrangement of teeth on the jaw. There are 4 types of human dentition. First one is bunodont. If I am saying human dentition is bunodont, then what is the meaning of bunodont? The cusp shape of human teeth is rounded. The cusp shape of teeth in human is rounded. You can say it is kind of round, rounded. So we can say if the cusp of teeth is rounded, then dentition is referred as bunodont. Cusp shape is rounded. Next is heterodont. If human beings have different types of teeth on the basis of structure and function, they are referred as heterodont. Means they have different types of teeth in a same jaw. As I told you that they have 4 types of teeth, incisor, canine, premolar and molar. So if human beings have if any individual have same type of teeth, then they are referred as homodont. And if they have different type of teeth in a same jaw, then they are referred as, on the behalf of a structure and function, then they are referred as heterodont. Then second dentition is heterodont and third is thecodont. If I am saying that human dentition is thecodont, then what is the meaning of thecodont? As we know that the teeth is embedded or fitted in the socket of jawbone or alveolar bone. Socket of jawbone or alveolar bone. This type, the teeth, or we can say the root part of teeth, is completely embedded in the embedded into the socket of jawbone, and this type of teeth is referred as thecodont. If the teeth is completely embedded into the socket of jawbone, teeth is completely embedded into the socket of jaw bone, that is also referred as alveolar or alveoli. And this alveolar is covered with the gingiva or gums. Next is monophyodont. What is monophyodont? If any appear only once in a life, then it is referred as monophyodont. If any set of teeth appear only once in a lifespan, then they are referred as monophyodont. And what teeth in case of human beings are monophyodont? That is premolars, and last molar. This is very important point. Premolar and last molar, or we can also say wisdom teeth. Here, one thing you can conclude that earlier I told you dental formula of adult and dental formula of child. So this is dental formula of adult and this is dental formula of child. And here you can see this is the dental formula of child: incisor, canine, premolar and molar. So in case of adult, this is premolar, canine, incisor, canine, premolar and molar. Here you can see this is premolar and this is premolar. In case of child, premolar are absent, or in case of adult, they are present. It means they are erupt or appear only once in a life. Let's understand with another example. If you are talking about this, I told you that temporary teeth appear or erupted or begin to erupt it at the age of 6 months and lost it. Notice the point, lost at the age of 6 to 12 years. It means they just lost and again erupted at the age of 6 to adulthood. It means they appear twice in a lifespan. It means they are diphyodont. If any teeth that appear or erupted twice in a lifespan, then it is referred as diphyodont. So, which teeth in case of human being are diphyodont? You can see here the teeth present in both child and adult. That teeth is referred as diphyodont. It means incisor is also present, canine is also present. What absent in child and what present in adult? That is premolars. So premolars are the monophyodont. They appear only once in a life in case of adult. And next is molars. In case of child, there are 2 molars are present, and in case of adult, 3 molars are present. And what absent in case of child? That is last molar. That is also referred as wisdom teeth. So monophyodont teeth in case of human beings are premolars and last molar. Rest of teeth, that is incisor, canine and 2 molars, are referred as diphyodont teeth because they appear twice in a lifespan. And how we can find it? If just see the dental, just compare the dental formula of both adult and child, and you can just see here incisor is also present in adult and child, canine is also present and molars is also present except the last molar. So they are just diphyodont teeth. Study about salivary gland. Salivary gland secretes saliva. They secrete saliva all the time, but the moment when food enter into our buccal cavity, saliva secretion is increases. Secrete saliva. There are 3 pair of salivary gland present in case of human being. 3 pair of salivary gland present. And they are located just outside the buccal cavity. You can see here, this is buccal cavity, this is tongue, and this is buccal cavity. And they are just located outside the buccal cavity. So, how they can question on how they pour their saliva to the buccal cavity. Because saliva is secreted inside the buccal cavity, there are different ducts to corresponding salivary gland which secretes saliva to the buccal cavity. So this is parotid. There are three type of salivary gland. This is parotid. This is submandible. It is also referred as submaxillary. Submaxillary. And below the tongue, the other type of salivary gland is located, that is referred as sublingual. Sublingual. You can see the location of parotid gland. It is located just below the ear. So we have two pair of ear, and below the each ear there are parotid gland. So there are two means one pair of salivary gland and one maxillary submaxillary gland. Location of submaxillary gland, try to imagine, they are located at the junction of both upper and lower jaw. They are located at the junction of where our upper jaw and lower jaw meet, at the junction of upper and lower jaw they are located. And sublingual, as the name suggests, it located just below the tongue, on the ventral side of the tongue it is located, hence referred as sublingual. And as I told you that they are located just outside the buccal cavity, and they secrete saliva inside the buccal cavity with the corresponding duct. Let's see the name of these ducts. Parotid gland secretes saliva inside the buccal cavity through a duct referred as Stenson's duct. Referred as Stenson's duct. I'm repeating. Parotid gland located below the ear secretes saliva inside the buccal cavity through the Stenson's duct. Next is submaxillary or sublingual. It is located at the junction of upper and lower jaw, where our upper and lower jaw meet. They are located, and this secretes saliva inside the buccal cavity through a duct referred as, this is the duct that carries saliva inside the buccal cavity, referred as Watson's duct. Next is sublingual. It located just below the tongue, on the ventral side, it secretes saliva through a duct referred as, these are the duct, smaller ducts, duct of Ravenous, duct of Ravenous, or also referred as Bartholin duct, Bartholin duct. So parotid gland secretes saliva inside the buccal cavity through the Stenson's duct. Submaxillary or submandible secrete the saliva through the Watson's duct, and duct sublingual secrete the saliva inside the buccal cavity through the duct of Ravenous or Bartholin duct. And let's see, in these three glands, salivary gland, which is largest and which is the smallest, parotid is largest gland. Parotid is largest gland. Don't confuse with the word. In these three salivary gland, parotid is largest and sublingual is smallest. Sublingual is smallest. So parotid is largest and sublingual is smallest. Let's talk about the duct. Here you can see Stenson's duct is smaller duct, and duct of Ravenous, you can see here with the diagram, they are the smallest duct. Smallest duct. And submaxillary or submandible secrete their saliva through the duct referred as Watson's duct. Referred as Watson's duct. It is the largest duct. It is the longest duct. Sorry. it is the longest duct. So let's have a quick recap with the help of table. Carotid gland, submandible, sublingual. Location of these glands, as I told you, they are located outside the buccal cavity. Parotid is located below the ear. Submandible located at the junction of upper and lower jaw. And sublingual just located below the tongue. So this is about location of these glands, and let's see the size of these glands. Parotid is largest and sublingual is smallest. Next, the duct through which, or opening duct, the duct through which they secrete saliva, into the buccal cavity. So name of these duct, through which these glands secrete saliva inside the buccal cavity. For parotid, the duct that secretes saliva inside the buccal cavity is Stenson's duct. And in case of mandible, the name of duct is Wharton's duct. And in case of sublingual, it is duct of Ribbenis or Bartholin duct. Let's see the size of these duct. As I told you that size of the sublingual is smallest and bottom's duct is longest. And in between both, the Stenson's duct are. Next is the opening place of these duct inside the buccal cavity. Let's see the place of opening duct inside the buccal cavity. Where opens the Stenson's duct inside the buccal cavity? Where open Wharton duct inside the buccal cavity? And where duct of Ribbenis? So location of or opening of duct inside the buccal cavity. Opening of duct. Stenson's duct opens in the upper vestibule. What is upper vestibule? If you remember the lecture related to the buccal cavity, I told you that buccal cavity is divided into oral cavity and main oral cavity and oral vestibule. And I told you that what is oral vestibule? Oral vestibule is the space between the cheeks and gums. So upper jaw and lower jaw both have vestibule. In upper jaw, upper vestibule, and lower jaw, lower vestibule. So Stenson's duct open into the upper vestibule. Let's see the opening of Wharton's duct inside the buccal cavity. It opens into the lower incisor. It opens at the lower incisor. The place where lower incisor is present, this is our jaw and here incisor. So at the front where lower incisor are present, at that point they open Next, opening of sublingual duct inside the buccal cavity. It opens below the tongue. Below the tongue. In buccopharyngeal cavity. Buccopharyngeal cavity. So, Stenson's duct open into the upper vestibule, Watson's duct open into the near the lower incisor, and duct of Frobenius opens at below the jaw. Sorry, below the tongue. Let's see which salivary gland secrete maximum saliva. There are three type of salivary gland: parotid, submandibular, and sublingual. 75% of saliva secreted by submandibular, and rest of 25% secreted by parotid and sublingual. So clearly remember this point that submandibular or submaxillary gland secrete 70%, 75% of the saliva, of total saliva. Next, see how much saliva secreted per day. Approx 1.5 liter saliva secreted per day. About 1.5 liter saliva secreted per day. Let's see what is the pH of saliva. It is 6.8. We can say slightly acidic. Slightly acidic. Next, composition of saliva. Composition of saliva. Consists of 95% of water. Mucus. Electrolytes. Like sodium ion. K+ ion. Bicarbonate ion. Contain antibody, that is IgA, provide immunity to individual. Next is lysozyme. It is also enzyme. Lysozyme. It is a bactericidal enzyme. Lysozyme is bactericidal enzyme. It kills the bacteria. If suppose we ingest food that is contaminated or infected with any kind of bacteria, it kills the bacteria. So saliva also provide first line of defense. Saliva also provide first line of defense because it contains IgA and lysozyme. And lysozyme is bactericidal, means it kills the bacteria that is present in food. However, if it will be ingested. Next, it consists of a most important enzyme that is referred as salivary amylase. Salivary amylase, also referred as ptyalin. P is silent here. Salivary amylase, most important enzyme of saliva because it responsible for the biochemical digestion of starches, means the moment food reached into the buccal cavity, starch digestion started with the help of enzyme salivary amylase, that is ptyalin. So let's see the composition. 95% water, and it also consists mucus. What is the function of mucus? Mucus just provide lubrication to the food, or it help in adherence of food particles, so that food particles adhere to form bolus, and it can easily pass through the buccal cavity to the esophagus. And electrolytes, they just act as the buffer for the saliva and IgA. IgA is an antibody. Antibody, it provide defense to the individual and lysozyme, it kill the bacteria present in the food. And most important enzyme of the saliva, that is slavy amylase, and is also referred as styrene or alpha amylase. Alpha amylase, because the moment food enter into the buccal cavity, starch digestion is started with the help of enzyme that is referred as slavy amylase, most important enzyme. Note the point. Let's have a quick review about quick recap about the salivary glands. Salivary glands generally present in three pairs. In case of human being, it secretes saliva all the time. But at the time or at the moment when food enter into the buccal cavity, saliva secretion increased. And in one day or per day, approximately 1.5 liter of saliva secreted. And what is the pH of saliva? It is 6.8. We can say it's slightly acidic. There are three pairs of salivary gland, that is parotid, submandible and sublingual. Let's see the location of these glands. They are located, parotid located just below the ear, and submandible or submandibular located below at the jaw, at the junction of upper and lower jaw, and sublingual located below the tongue. As they are located outside the buccal cavity, but they secrete saliva inside the buccal cavity. So there are corresponding duct which secretes saliva into the buccal cavity. For parotid gland, Stenson's duct is that secretes saliva inside the buccal cavity. And for submandible or submaxillary, there is another duct referred as Wharton duct that secretes saliva inside the buccal cavity. It opens near the lower incisor. Next, sublingual located below the tongue, and it secretes saliva inside the buccal cavity through the duct of Ribbenis or Bartholin duct. Duct of Ribbenis or Bartholin duct is smallest duct, and Wharton duct is longest duct. And if we are talking about these three glands, that is parotid, submaxillary and sublingual, then in these three, parotid is the largest gland and sublingual is the smallest gland. So, this is about salivary gland.